Hi guys, Dorota Palicka, international nail artist and educator here, and I'm in with Fiona, and we are gonna sculpt an almond shape nails. I will show you on those 8 ones. We will do the thumb in the next video together with the design, so you have to subscribe if this is your first video you are watching. That's the forms we are gonna use, and we have done an almond shape on Fiona 3, 4, 5 years ago, last time. She has been wearing a coffin shape for a long time. She's one of the clients which I don't need to trim the forms much. And this is actually awesome because it speed up the process. So, but I'm always hiding a client view. I did carry it out the removal of the previous nail extension. There was a video of them as well. They were really nice and beautiful, lots of glitter going on. Actually really awesome set, so if you didn't see that, just go and watch it as well. I'm always putting this on the back of the form just to make my form a little bit stiffer. Then close the wings, like make sure they are all close nicely together, and then slide the form, like making sure the middle is in the middle. And once I've got the middle, I can start closing it, but I want the form to run nice and like straight. Like I don't want the form to drop down. I really want the form to be straight, like as much as possible, because then the things looks prettier. It doesn't matter what shape I'm kind of doing. Like I don't like the nails which are dropping down, so I'm very careful when it comes to when it comes to the form application. Again, close those wings and slide the form. So that's me having on 3 forms, and I think it's a time to start sculpting the set, because I like when the things are kind of cooking and when we speed up the things. I'm just gonna check this ring finger form. That's it. So it is actually dropping a little bit, and I'm gonna touch it up, so loosen it up and lift it up. If it's impossible to do that, sometimes you have to just remove the form and start again. It's better, guys, because the way you apply the forms, that's the shape you are gonna get. Now we've got the extra nail prep, which dehydrates the nail plate further, just because we have touched it during the form application and everything. When this is drying, I might have a time to put another form, and with another form the things are a little bit tougher because I need to cut a space for hyponychium. So Fiona has like been wearing the nail extensions for many years. We can't even remember, 14, 15 years, like she's a client of mine. And her short nail beds have grown into a long nail beds with high hyponychium. Hyponychium is a skin which lies directly underneath living tissue, underneath of the free edge of the nail, like it's almost like an extension of a nail bed, and you have to be very careful, like placing the products, removing the products, and shaping those places, because it can be very painful for a client if you file that, because it's a living tissue. And its function is to protect the nail bed from any nail infection. I'm applying Universal Airbond, and my Universal Airbond acts as a base gel. Okay, so that's why, like, I also do not shorten the free edge maybe the way I wish to shorten it, because it will just physically hurt my client. Perfect Rose, that's a gel we are gonna sculpt, because depending what I'm doing, like if there is any see-through places, I prefer to go for this gel because it has a slightest coverage function as well, so it will cover and conceal nicely any places I want. Okay, that's me ready for a first nail, and it just clicked into my head that we're actually doing a different shape. So nice and thin layer through the entire nail plate. Pick up another scoop of the product, and then we are gonna extend our free edge. So this time we are gonna go for a pointy almond shape for a change. Quite nice and long. So with Fiona's nails, like when I sculpting a fresh set, I'm going kind of longer, and then as they grow, we keep shortening them, just so the nails last better and there is not that much of a movement. Depending on the temperatures in a salon and depending on the client temperatures, I will do either one or two nails. In this case, I can do two nails. Again, make sure those free edge is touched. And then we are gonna go for a letter M. I always do it a little bit more than I need to with this thin layer, just so later on I do not miss any product. And I always apply quite a big bulk at those free edge. And then give it a cure. Don't bang the form. Fiona is very good with her forms usually. I don't do many clients actually with the full form application, guys, because check, I've got hyponychium here as well. You can probably even see it. So that's the hyponychium we was talking about, and I need to cut out the space for it as well. So not many clients get actually a sculpted set. Some of them just go for a cheaper option, which is tips. I just find it like, I don't know, the sculpted set just looks better. It just follows the natural nail, and it tends to last better as well, I would say. It's like kind of almost custom fit. So nice and straight, find the middle and then start closing the form. Check if you're happy with it. And because I want my right hand to be ready first, I'm just doing one nail in here. And again, when I've got drying time, I will be preparing another form. This one goes on nice and beautiful. It's pinched amazing as well, because I'm trying to make them like as slim as possible at the same time as well. Wait a couple seconds for it to dry. And then nice and thin layer. Pick up the scoop of the product. Apply it everywhere. And extend the free edge. So here I've got two nails done. This one is all good. I can pull the form out, which will make my life much comfier and the client life comfier as well. Even putting the hand inside the lamp, I'm checking this one. Lots of product in here. And then again, an extra nail prep. So this nail was badly damaged last time, and the client applied even the nail glue over it. And today I have glued it the sites where the nail is broken. File away this glue, so the glue is only stocked in those broken points, and then prep the entire nail. Like this way, it will kind of straighten it a little bit. Again, cap those free edge and extend it. Again, prep those ones. Nice and thin. And then scoop of the product. Recheck the form, because sometimes like it can be touched during the time when the client puts it into the lamp. But as I say, Fiona is very good with her hands, like, and she usually she doesn't bang. We had some things when she bangs as well, but yeah, usually she doesn't. Change. Okay, so again, I cannot remove the middle finger yet, just because it might be not cured properly. Okay, I can definitely remove the form from this one. Again, make my life easier and apply another form. Guys, I do also keep this for a nail art. Like, it's an amazing way. Like, instead of going to the bin, I'm just keeping it, and then I can just use it as my mixing palette. An awesome tip for you guys if you're using a sculpting forms. Again, try to hide the client view, especially that those both of the ring fingers are growing different directions. So I'm always trying to find a happy medium. It is not so noticeable like with the new set, but when we've got the old nails, like you can really see it. You can really see it. Wait for it to dry a couple seconds. And then universal air bond. Again, thin layer and scoop of the product. Okay, I can remove this one and I can start building the apex. So, very thin layer, and now in my head I need to imagine the shape of this nail, because I'm placing the second layer of the product only on those places where I want to product to stay in, and the rest is going to be filed in. But because it's so thin, it's so easy to file. I just find it, I do prefer it doing that way, so I definitely do not miss any product. So building my apex, I'm just working one side, other side, to the point I am happy with the length change. This part can get hot, so I'm always warning my clients and I advise them to remove their nails like after a couple seconds and then put the hand back in. So remove it so it doesn't get hot and then put it back in. I can apply form on the pinky. And because we have managed to pinch them so nice with the form application, I don't actually have to even pinch them much. To save the time, I'm applying product here, and now I have no form, so the things are very comfy. I can touch up any corners, any missing places, like making sure I've got product everywhere. So this is me doing it with this thin layer. I also have enough product around the cuticle area, and now I'm picking up a large scoop of the product to build up my apex again. And again, only in the places where I want the product and in a correct shape. Okay, remove the excess of the product and then help it spread a little bit. Look, it does the job change itself, and that's why I love it. Like, it just speeds up your work. Like, the entire top is nice and smooth, and like, you know, those edges are so thin that they are going to be very easy to file. So one more time, nice and thin layer, nice and thin layer. Pick up the scoop of the product and usually try to place it on the one side of your brush, like just so it's easier to control it, almost released from your brush. And once you've got it, start pulling one side, other side, one side, other side. Do not go too close to the sides, because by the time you touch it up, the product will just fill in there, like run in there, like, but we want that, you know, like this is a way we want it. Nice and perfect change. Look, minimal brush brush work. So first of all, you are creating less air bubbles in a product, and you speed up your work as well. I can do it this one now as well, so nice and thin, nice and thin. So with this length, like, I would usually book like at least 2 hours for a new set, sculpted set. On the tips, about an hour and a half. It's a pretty long appointment. And then the removal, it can take some time to change. Okay, we are ready for check. I can pull this form away. Very comfy for a client now. And build up the apex here. So again, a nice and thin layer. Get it everywhere. Cap those free edge. Cap those free edge. Apply the product here as well, just so you don't have missing places. And then pick up the scoop. So usually try to kind of measure the scoop you want to pick up. Again, get rid from the brush, just so it's easier. Touch and release, and then start pulling it down into like kind of almost reverse smile line. Remove the excess, and then watch the gel to just go into the correct places. See, it's kind of does the job itself. Change. So I can remove the form in here. I need you closer, so we're in the camera. Yeah, at the same time watching if we're still in the camera. I'm really enjoying doing those videos, guys, for you, like, but please also bear with me. Like, I mean, recording from the salon involves, like, working in a salon and involves, like, lots of stuff going on, because we've got phone calls going on, clients walking in, recording, doing a client news as well, and, like, controlling all the stuff around me. So it is really sometimes quite a lot of task to take on, but yeah, I'm trying, like, I know, guys, you're enjoying those videos from the salon, so I'm trying, like, as much as possible, remove those bubbles, change. Perfect. Yeah, I really enjoy recording also on Fiona, because she knows what she's doing. Remember, never force the client to hold the hand inside, or never hold it yourself. If you feel the heat spike, you always want to remove it. Okay, again, get this product off from my brush. Released it, and I'm just gonna show you, like, how little I'm trying to touch the actual gel. Remove the excess, and don't touch the product. Change. So it is pretty hard to learn that, because automatically we start to playing with our brush and making mess of it. I find it, like, doing this way is the fastest way to do a set of the nail extensions on the forms. And on the tips as well, because my application of the apex is just exactly the same. So I have no form, I can easily really reach any place I need to, like, I can go very close to the cuticle, nothing to worry about. And then my apex, again, release from the brush. If you do not release it from a brush, it's gonna be harder to do it so on the nails. It's off from my brush, and then leave more product. So stay in this place for longer, and then just drag it faster, so you leave less product behind. Remove the excess. That's it, change. Reinspect this hand. Everything good, enough product, They are gonna be nice and straight. Fiona touched this finger, maybe? No, she didn't. Okay, now we are just gonna give them full cure, so change. Perfect, so we can apply the apex in here. Okay, that was back again. yeah, that's what I was saying, like, you know, doing everything at once. So I do pull the form from here as well. Again, a nice and thin layer. Nice and thin layer, and I have to watch because quite often the pink is like got different direction, so ideally you want to ask the clients to keep the pinky nice and straight so the product doesn't run in there. Pick up the scoop, and this scoop is much smaller because obviously the pinky is much smaller. I take into the consideration that my client might twist the hand a little bit, and look what I'm doing, I'm just doing a little bit offside. So I've got more to the left side and less to the right side because automatically those fingers might run that direction. Change. And in this time, this hand is ready for filing. How awesome is this? Like, so there is no waiting time, guys. Like, you just keep going and working all the time. Remove the inhibition layer. Okay, clean them nice. So it's really nice to do like a fresh set after the removal. First of all, we want to file on the one side, other side, and you want to, even if it's an almond shape, you want to keep your side walls nice and straight. So like here, I wanted it nice and straight, parallel to each other. File the free edge, so I can file it like decent amount of the product, but it doesn't take me long time. I need to lift the things up, so basically exactly the same. This is my filing technique, which I use just for every client, like constantly the same. Check if the side walls are lower arches are equal. Blend around the cuticle area. Smooth out the entire nail, like, and apex places, we don't have to touch it much. Now, I usually do not finish the filing completely until I do entire set because I want them to be the same. So I will just leave it at this stage. Again, file one side, other side. Look, very quick and easy to file. And because we didn't mess up the top, it looks quite nice and okay straight away, you know? Make the lower arches equal. Lift the side walls up, blend around the cuticle area. Like everything blend nicely. Thin out the free edge. And usually I try to don't file the apex area. Okay, I would check it if it's all nice and equal. Okay, I've got second one, which I believe is too long compared to the other ones, but I'm gonna leave it at this stage because I can always shorten it later on if it's needed. Nice and pointy almond. My clients don't like the sidewalls to be too low and too heavy. And you do see it, like, you know, when they come back for a rebalance, that their nails last, they don't break them. Like, I mean, they do sometimes break them, don't get me wrong. We sometimes all break the nail. But it's not something like, I don't know, like an excessive matter. Definitely this one needs to go shorter. Even them out. Blend the things together. nice and pointy. Remove the excess from the free edge. So usually the free edge, I want the credit card thickness, and then all this product, all this bulk is at my apex area. Definitely taper it and shorten it straight away. Each time when I'm shortening the nail, I need to thin out the free edge. Honestly, I can't remember when it was always coffin shape, like, so it's nice to do this one for a change. Especially that not many clients actually suit both shapes, and Fiona suits both of them, so it doesn't matter what shape they are, she suits both of the shapes. Thin out the free edge. And my tear on the glove is getting just bigger and bigger. Blend around the cuticle area. Check the client view. So I do really love checking the client view. Too much bulk in here, and they are nice and thin. So I just need to touch up this nail here. I'm pretty happy with it, so just grab the buffer, remove the sharp edges from it. And then using the buffer, we are gonna smooth out the entire surface. So you want to blend everything around this cuticle area here. You don't want to show where the product is starting. Nice and gentle, nice and fast in the middle. I'm usually using also the buffer to touch up and perfect the free edge. Move on into the next one. Blend everything in here. Check it, and the same. Nice and gentle. inspect them again, and then that's this hunt ready. And we are able to do it exactly the same on the other hand. So yeah, I'm just gonna file it and then show you the final look. Okay, that is awesome, guys. So I have quickly buffed the other hand and shaped it as well. Now we need to clean the client's hands, like, and obviously we'll go and wash them as well before the design. I can see it, this hand here, and I'm just quickly cleaning this hand too, so I can show you the final results for this set. And we are not going to top coat it, we are not going to do any nail art on it, because of course in the next video I will show you a beautiful design on those nails. And I hope you have guys really enjoyed learning those shape as well. So pointy almond, I'm sending you huge glittery hacks. And if you really like our fiber perfect rose gel, you can grab it from our website, which will be listed in the description of this video. Huge glittery hacks, and see you in the next one. Bye.